The Apache RR 310 is the most powerful motorcycle from TVS. It's a full-fed sport bike, it has great fit and finish, and it's been designed to be easy to live with, be it daily riding or be it occasional track duties, should you wish to improve your riding skills on a racetrack. And it's priced at 2 lakh rupees, just above 2 lakh rupees, ex-showroom.
Well, the Thunderbird 500X is also priced just below 2 lakh rupees. It's essentially a modern contemporary take on the Thunderbird 500. It's got slight changes. Essentially, the engine is the same, the chassis is the same. It's also designed for day-to-day use, keeping in mind. So both these bikes, that's where the similarities end. They're in this more or less the same price bracket, but they are completely different motorcycles, so to say.
But many of you might still consider either one if that's your budget, so here goes. The RR310 is built to go fast and do it in style, dropping jaws everywhere you go. The Thunderbird 500X is more suited for relaxed, laid-back riding style.
The Apache RR310, if it gets full marks for one thing, it has to be the motorcycle's road presence.
Absolutely.
It's really, really solid. The bike looks much bigger than what it is, and it looks like a middleweight super sport. And it's loaded to the brim with features. It gets a vertically stacked all-digital instrument panel, LED projector headlamps, fat upside-down forks up front, and dual-channel ABS as well.
Yeah. Well, the Thunderbird 500X is the most expensive motorcycle from the Royal Enfield stable. It's essentially still a Thunderbird 500, but it gets the blacked-out look to give it fresh appeal. And it gets alloy wheels and tubeless tires, the first time ever on a Royal Enfield motorcycle. It gets disc brakes, both front and rear, but ABS is still not offered, even as an option.
Both motorcycles have completely different riding dynamics and characteristics. We found the RR310 to be much more enjoyable and engaging when it comes to sheer riding joy. The Thunderbird 500 is meant for riders who like to take it easy, be it on the daily ride or the occasional long distance run. The RR310 loves to be revved and ridden hard. It is a performance bike after all, and with all that power coming in late, the higher end of the rev range is where all the fun lies. Acceleration is brisk, and so it leaves the Thunderbird 500X far behind. Plus, with its good handling and committed posture, the RR310 is great fun around the racetrack too. Thunderbird 500X though is a torque monster, but it feels most comfortable chugging along at speeds of 80 to 90 km per hour on straight roads. And the new flat handlebar and new tubeless tires make the 500X feel more eager to turn and more planted around the corner than any other Royal Enfield. It also has the plusher ride of the two. Bumps, potholes and broken roads are no problem for this cruiser. And so compared to the 500X, the RR310 definitely has a slightly stiffer ride. Where the Thunderbird 500X tops out in terms of speed, that is exactly where the Apache RR310 will begin stretching its legs and will easily go faster. The RR310's brakes are also much better and offer sure shot stopping power.
So after a good day of hard riding, these motorcycles have sprung one last surprise.
Yes, absolutely.
And apart from the pricing, these motorcycles have one more thing in common, which is vibrations. It really kind of dampens your riding experience.
Well, yes, the Royal Enfields have always been vibey engines. If you ride it at 3500 RPM, around 90 km per hour, they're okay. If you go beyond that, anything above 3500, the vibrations start getting to you from the foot pegs to your handlebar to everything. The TVS Apache RR, on the other hand, vibrates a little bit. You still feel the vibrations on the seat, on the tank, on the foot pegs, but they smoothen out somewhat, isn't it?
Yes.
As you increase the revs. It's actually a matter of personal choice really on what kind of rider you are. If you're the kind of rider who's a sporty rider who wants to do the daily commute on the bike and wants to do a few laps on a racetrack, then the TVS Apache RR 310 is the bike for you.
Absolutely.
And on the other hand, if you're a Royal Enfield fan, then we don't have to say anything really, do we?